everyone, what's up and thank you so much for visiting my channel. So guys, for today's video, I am again going to do a DIY because I think that after completing 1K, I should do a video which is actually very loved by you, and it is going to be DIY plus art and craft. So DIY plus art and craft means today we are going to make a DIY art and craft stationery kit, art and craft kit, anything like that. So till now I have tried a lot of craft kits in which you get different type of material, but every kit costs more than 500 or 600 rupees, which is so today I'm going to just make a DIY art and craft kit at home, and it will cost you less than 200 rupees. I'm just betting you. So yeah, in this there will be same material as you get from the shopkeeper. Even it will be better because you will be able to customize it according to your needs. And yeah, in this I have used very less ready-made products. Mostly I have curated the products by my own. See it guys. And now coming on to the collaboration part guys, today I have collabed with two channels actually, and two channels are Nandini Creations and All in One Creativity with Gaushya. So guys, please check out those two channels. They are very interesting, and both of the channels are very nice. They make different types of DIY videos, and also they organize very cute giveaways as well for their fam. So you can check out the channels, and the link is given in the description. So link is given in the description box, so please go and check it out. So yes guys, without any further ado, let's get started saying that how can you create a craft kit for yourself.
So yes guys, let's get started. First of all, I'm going to take these strips of golden glitter foam sheets, and these were left from my last project. Now I'm going to use this type of a star punch so that I can punch out some stars. If you don't have golden glitter foam sheet, then definitely you can go with normal foam sheets, and you can also go with A4 size paper. Now I'm going to cut out some mini stars from the punch. You can use any punch which you have. If you don't have punch, then you can just randomly do them by your hand with the help of a scissor, but it will not give you as clean look as a punch will give. So that's why you can use these punches to cut out some cute designs. And these punches are very affordable, only 40 rupees for one punch. So yes guys, they are even very affordable if you can buy the whole set. Now here I just punched out a lot of cute little glitter stars, and now I'm just going to pack them inside a Ziploc pouch. Here I was just cutting the extra Ziploc pouch with the help of a paper knife. Don't use paper knife if you are under 7 years. And here are our cute stars. Now I'm going to use this orange foam sheet, and with the help of a pencil I'm just going to cut out a little rectangle from the foam sheet. Here I'm going to use scissors. Sorry, here I am using the paper cutter. If you don't have paper cutter, then definitely you can use the scissors. And if you are 7 years old or younger than that, so then definitely you should not go with these type of paper cutters. You can definitely take help from your elderly. Now from this rectangle I'm going to cut out some strips, and these are going to be foam sheet strips which are very useful in the projects. So yes guys, try to make them of equal size, like equal width and length. If you can't understand any step from the whole process, then definitely you can email me. Email ID in the description box. So here I'm having 3 strips of orange foam sheet, and here I made many more. So I got 3 from the white foam sheet, 3 from blue foam sheet, and 3 from orange ones. And now I'm just going to pack them in the Ziploc pouch. If you don't have Ziploc pouches, then definitely you can ignore this step. After that, here I'm going to take this 100 GSM A4 paper, a pink one and a orange one. And from this also, I'm going to cut out some strips. And we are making some designer strips right now. So here I'm having this orange strip and this very cute mini punch. And this is a flower punch. So I'm going to punch some flowers out on equal intervals on the strip. See yes, guys. And I'm going to cut out the X's. If you're not able to understand, please email me right now. And yeah, here we go. So here's our designer strip. And please don't throw these type of mini flowers which are left after punching. So yes, So cut out different patterns on each strip. Here I was cutting out these emojis on the pink strip. And for the bottom part, here I'm not using the normal scissor. Here I'm using this designer scissor, which is easily available in any type of a craft store. So our cute strips are ready, and now we are just going to pack it in a Ziploc pouch. After that, we are going to take these remains which were left after punching, and these are very, very cute. So we are just going to take them and we are going to pack them inside a mini Ziploc pouch. So yeah, very useful, right? Now here I'm going to use this A4 sheet, which is in white color. Actually, this is a piece of A4 sheet, sis. After that, here I'm going to use a circular punch and I'm going to cut out some circles so you can see that how useful these punches are. Now I'm going to take some black sheet and I'm going to cut a little smaller circles, and then I'm going to stick them on the white circles, and I'm going to make some googly eyes type of thing. They are not very similar to googly eyes, but yeah, these are a little bit. And now we are just going to pack them inside a Ziploc pouch. Now here I'm taking these ice cream sticks which are self-painted. If you don't have self-painted ones, then you can definitely paint them by yourself. And here I'm just going to pack them inside a Ziploc pouch. You know that how useful these are. Now here I'm taking this A4 sheet, 100 USM. And after that I'm going to take a scale and my pencil. And then I'm going to just cut out a little rectangle from the A4 sheet. Here I was using scissors. So with the help of my tape right now, here I'm using my tape and sketch pen to make some circles, and then I'm going to color them with the help of my crayons. I'm just coloring them in different colors. You can use either one color or different type of colors as I am doing. So yes, and we are making some cut out emoji stickers right now. So here I'm making different type of emojis on each circle, and you can just cut them and then you can use them for the project which you are making. I'm just going to make some cute cheeks, and now I'm going to use this designer scissor to cut the borders. And then I'm just going to pack them in a Ziploc pouch. If you don't want to make emojis, then you can make flowers, anything which you like. Now here I'm going to take this piece of plastic which I got from a polythene bag, and then I'm just going to stick these type of beads and cute stickers on it. These are reusable, to be honest. So yes, guys. So I just sticked some ready-made stickers on it. If you want me to show that how to make DIY stickers, then definitely tell me in the comment section. Now here I'm going to take these thermocol balls and I'm going to pack them inside a Ziploc pouch. And these are very easily available in any craft store. You can get these for 15 rupees only. And now we are just going to pack these thermocol balls inside a Ziploc pouch. And here we go. After that, from my bead box, here I'm taking some beads, and now we are just going to put them inside a matchstick box, and I'm just going to decorate the box with the help of some golden glitter washi tape. And yes, I'm going to decorate the cover also with the silver tape. And yes, here is our very beautiful container, small little container for our little beads. So who will say that this was a matchstick box before? After that, here I'm taking some ready-made origami paper. This is easily available in the local market just for 10 rupees. You can even go with designer origami sheets. And yes, after that, here I'm taking the orange A4 sheet 100 USM again. And here I'm cutting out some strips, try to make them equal. And here we are making DIY quilling strips. And I'm going to cut out some strips from the pink paper as well. Now we are just going to pack them together. You can use different type of colored strips also. And then I'm just going to put them inside a Ziploc pouch. So they were not inserting properly when I was doing like this. So I just bent them so that they can go inside easily. And here we go. Now let's add all the stuff. So here I'm going to take some origami sheet. And here I'm going to take these DIY quilling strips. And I'm going to add these DIY strips, which are designer ones. These DIY foam sheet strips. And now we are going to add these self-painted ice cream sticks. And these thermocol balls. These type of googly type of eyes. And these type of cutout emoji stickers. We We are adding each thing in this good quality plastic box. Now we are adding these bead box, mini stars which we made, and I'm going to add a black sketch pen, toothpicks which are very useful for the projects, these type of tapes, and this ready-made stickers, and a craft punch. I'm going to add this emoji pencil. You can know how to make this by seeing my DIY emoji kit video. Here I'm adding this liquid glue and this fevi stick. I'm also going to add this paper cutter. You can decrease or increase any item in this kit. I'm going to add this little scissor. I'm going to add this pen. And this big one scissor. And we are just going to pack it. And we added all the things in this transparent box. Here I was adding a mini cutter as well. And here we go. Very cute, right?
Yes, guys, this was the kit. And I'm so sorry for making this video a long one. Because, see, Art and Craft has a lot of items which you have to use. So today I have shared some of them. I really hope that you like this video. And if yes, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also press that bell 20 so that you can be notified whenever I upload a new video. And